Hi, welcome back to the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. I'm Jesus Ramirez. In this video, I'm going to show you a cool masking technique that I just came up with. I was recently at Creative Live's Photoshop Week. I was one of the instructors there. And in one of my sessions, I got a really, really interesting question, and I came up with an answer on the spot. This video is going to be about expanding on that answer. So before we go any further, let me show you what that question was.
Bruce has been asking, is there a way to make a mask based on detail density? So he says that mask exists in Lightroom for the sharpening tool.
I see what he's saying, yeah.
But he'd like to use it in Photoshop, but can't figure out if that exists.
Well, that's a really good question. I'll show you what he means,
okay,
and then I'll see if I can figure it out.
Okay.
Good. That's a really good question.
So basically what that person was asking is how to use the Camera Raw or Lightroom mask in Photoshop. And if you don't know what that means, here, let me show you. In both Lightroom and Camera Raw, you have a masking slider in the Details tab. So this is Camera Raw. And if you go into the Details tab, you can see the sharpening. I can increase the sharpening by dragging on the slider. But you really can't tell what we're sharpening. And sure, we can zoom in to 100%, and we can actually see the sharpening being applied. But you can control what the sharpening is applied to by using this masking slider. If I drag the slider to the right, you'll notice that the effect is applied to different areas. But you really don't know what those areas are. But if I hold Alt, Option on the Mac and click on that slider and drag, you'll see this masking overlay. Black hides, white reveals. So we're revealing the sharpening effect only on the white areas. And that is what the person was referring to with the question. How can we get this mask into Photoshop? So now let me show you how I answer that question at Creative Live.
To be frank with you, I don't know of a specific way of doing it because I've never been asked that question, so now I'm trying to figure out how to do it. The one way, I don't know if this is the right answer, but this is the answer that I'm coming up with right now on the spot. So the way that I probably would do that would be by using maybe a filter. I think, let me see, what, maybe the fine edges filter? Yeah, maybe something like the fine edges filter, then press Control Shift U to desaturate. Press Control I, Command I to invert, and then I can use the image adjustment levels to, nice, you know, sort of find the right detail. Once I'm happy with it, remember what I said before, selections and masks are basically channels, you know, like a channel, so I'll just create a channel. So I'm going to go into the Channels panel, duplicate any one of the channels, they're all the same, because I'm working with black and white. Click and drag, duplicate it. Now if I hold Control, Command on the Mac, and click, I make a selection out of those edge pixels, and now I have a layer mask where it's just targeting the edges and details of the image. So that's one way I thought of doing it just on the spot. So I hope that works.
Now that I've had more time to think about it, I came up with a better way of doing it. So this is what this tutorial is all about. So let's get to it. We're going to work with this document. It's simply a portrait. And what I'm going to do first is right-click and convert it into a smart object to work non-destructively. Then I'm going to duplicate it by pressing Ctrl-J, Command-J on the Mac. So now we have an exact copy. Then I'm going to go into Image, Adjustment, Black and White to make it black and white. Simply press OK. Then I'm going to go into Filter and then Filter Gallery. I'm not going to use fine edges. Instead, under the stylize folder, I'm going to select glowing edges. Glowing edges allows you to find the edges of an image, and you have these sliders here to control how bright or dark those edges are. So this is very similar to the result that you would get with the masking slider in the sharpening tool with Lightroom and Camera Raw. Once you're happy, you can just press OK. If you need to fine-tune how dark or bright the edges are, you can go into Image, Adjustment, Levels, and you can fine-tune those edges by clicking and dragging on these sliders. Press OK when you're done. The advantage of working non-destructively with a smart object is that we have all those filters and adjustments here under the smart object, and you can edit them if you need to. For example, I can double-click on Filter Gallery, press OK. This is going to bring up the filter once again, and I can adjust the edges of my image. press OK when you're done. And we can simply make this into a selection by pressing Ctrl Alt and the number 2. That's Command Option 2 on the Mac. If you cannot remember the keyboard shortcut, you can simply go into the Channels panel and Control Click on any one of the channels. They are all the same since we are working with a black and white image. So I'm just going to Control Click, Command Click on the blue channel thumbnail, and that makes exactly that same selection. Once again, the keyboard shortcut for that is Control Alt and the number 2, and that loads the bright values of the image, so you're creating a luminosity mask. Then you can simply disable this layer. Then you can apply that selection to anything. In this case, I'll apply it to a layer mask, so I'll simply create a curves adjustment layer. And you can see that that selection was turned into a layer mask. If I hold Alt Option on the Mac and click on the layer mask thumbnail, you can actually see it. Alt Option on the Mac again and click on the layer mask thumbnail to hide it. And if I make an adjustment, you will see that these adjustments only are applied to the edges of the image. So this is a great way of creating a mask that is very similar to the masking slider inside of Lightroom and Camera Raw, but all inside of Photoshop. I'm not really sure how that person was going to use this masking technique that I just showed you, but I'm interested to know if you'll have a use for it. So let me know down in the comments below if you intend on using this technique in your projects. And by the way, if you want to learn more cool tricks with masking, then I have two great tutorials for you. First, how to mask hair from busy backgrounds in Photoshop, and also a quick 90-second tutorial where I show you a fantastic technique for replacing skies in Photoshop. I'll have a link to those two videos down below in the description. And there you have it. Let me know in the comments down below if you enjoy this technique. Also, if this is your first time at the Photoshop training channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe and notification buttons. Thanks so much for watching. I will see you at the next tutorial.